Hello friends, as you already know, my name is Durga and I'm currently working on a playlist which will help all the IT professionals who are using Windows laptops to learn new tools and techniques to boost their productivity and also to set up environment to explore all the latest and greatest technologies. As part of that, so far I have covered setting up Cygwin and tools like UltraEdit, and also setting up VM software on your laptop and then creating a virtual machine and installing OS, and then further steps that are required to make it working for you to learn new technologies. In this one, I will cover one important aspect of how you can actually make your virtual machine connect to internet and help you to install softwares using tools like yum, yum, and also wget to download softwares and set up them easily. So first, let us validate whether our VM is able to connect to internet or not. I have already logged in to the VM, and I can run ping www.google.com, and it says unknown host www.google.com. The reason is it is not able to resolve the name, and what we need to do to get the names resolved is we need to create a file called resolve.conf under etc, and then we need to add name server. So let us validate whether that file exists, etc resolve.conf. The file does not exist, so what we have to do is we have to define a name server. So name server, and name server should be 192.168.223, which we got from command prompt. I am showing again ipconfig on Windows command and VMnet 8 Ethernet adapter, VMware network adapter, VMnet 8. So if you look at IPv4 address, it says 192.168.223.1. So we need, and we have created gateway when we actually set up network earlier in etc sysconfig network file. So the same gateway we should add as name server in etc resolve.conf. So not cat, actually we have to use echo. So let me replace cat with echo. And then slash etc resolve.conf. Okay, now you can run lsltr command by clicking perl until you get the previous lsltr command, and now you can see the file and you can also etc and validate it. Okay, so it has the name server now. Now you can say ping www.google.com, and now it can ping the Google website. So now we can actually connect to the internet. So as we have the internet, we will also set up some softwares which we typically use on a regular basis, and these will be required on almost all VMs. Okay, and the softwares that we will be installing are so these are the softwares which we will install. Wget we will use to download any software using URL onto our VM directly without using our PC as staging. It will help. It will serve two purposes. One, you don't need to first download into your PC and then copy into the virtual machine. Two, typically when you do the copy from PC to virtual machine, you will have two copies of the same file, which is waste of storage. And three, you can actually run wget in nohop as a background process on a VM directly. And there are many such advantages. So we will install wget, and we need to install openssh to get our SCP working to our VM. And we need Perl for most of the purposes, and we need Java. And Java, I want to install 1.7.0 because as we speak, 1.8 is available, but there are so many softwares that might not be compatible with 1.8. 1.7 is the most stable version as we speak, so we will be installing 1.7.0 OpenJDK. Okay, so we can install all these things in one shot using something called yum install. Yum is for CentOS, Red Hat, Fedora, Oracle Linux. It will not work for Ubuntu. Ubuntu, you need to use apt-get. But in this case, we will be using yum because we are using CentOS. And install is its subcommand, and it takes update, remove, and other commands as well. And we can pass all the softwares in one command. OpenSSH, Perl, and Java 1.7.0 OpenJDK. And if we pass minus y, it will not ask you to prompt. So what will happen is yum is Red Hat flavor of installer, which will connect to the repositories over the network and download the software and install it for you. If you don't use yum, you have to copy the software, and you have to use RPM commands to install the software on your VM. Yum will automate all that process. So there will be some pre-configured repositories, and if you are interested and want to look at them, you can actually have a look at lsltr by running lsltr command against etc m.repos.d. And there are a bunch of files. So all these files will have URLs to the appropriate softwares, and we can actually use yum command to download any software that are there in repositories. If their URLs are created in these repo files. You also can have custom repositories. It's a little bit advanced. If you want to be a Linux admin, or if you want to be advanced user of Linux, understanding YAML server and other concepts are very important. But for us, it is not that important. So we will stop it over here and run the command. So now it is connecting to the internet, and it will install all the softwares. It will take little time, so I am pausing for now. In India, internet speed is very unstable and slow at most of the times, especially when you try to download. So this will take little bit more time if you are trying to download from in the countries like India. If it is in US, it will not take this long. I don't want your time to be wasted, so I'm just pausing it. And wherever I need to explain any item, I will come back and I will try to explain. So now the installation is going fine. Is still installing the packages. There are 68 packages that needs to be installed for whatever we have requested because of the dependencies and all. So let it download, and it has to download almost 50 megabytes. So the installation is done, and it took quite a while because of the internet speed. It failed once, and I reran the same command again. It failed because it could not connect to one of the mirrors to install Java. But when I ran the same command, everything is installed successfully. So if you see here, there was an error initially in installing Java, and I ran the same command again. Everything is downloaded and installed. So that being said, we are good with all the softwares we want to install, wget, openssh, perl, java, etc. And the way you can validate is you can run perl command. And I think perl, it will hang if it is working. Let me try perl version probably. Yeah, so it is working. And Java, we have downloaded 1.7. And if you run Java version command, you can see that 1.7 is installed. And also you can run wget and you can see the usage of wget. So all the softwares are installed successfully. So that being said, if you see, especially if the internet speed is slow, you should minimize connecting to internet and installing it onto your VMs as much as possible. And that we can achieve by creating a template and build on top of that for whatever technology you want to explore. For example, for Hadoop, if you want to build a 4-node cluster, we can clone this template, which have all the base, all the necessary softwares like Perl, Java, etc. We don't need to install all of them. We can just clone this into 4, and those 4 will already have these softwares. So that being said, that is it for this session. We have covered how to connect to the internet. We have to add name server on etcresolve.conf. And then also I have shown how to use Yum to connect to the public repositories and install the necessary softwares. I hope you are enjoying the series so far. Thank you very much. Bye.